Simplify your surveys, collect better data, and save time. Hello everyone, and welcome back to the PDF Element YouTube channel. If you're struggling to collect feedback or data from multiple people because your surveys feel boring, too long, or intimidating, you're in the right place. I'm Chris, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to give your surveys a fresh twist by transforming them into a whole new experience for both you and your participants using drop-down menus. Gathering feedback isn't always as straightforward as we would want it to be. Asking one person for their opinion is manageable, but when you're asking 100 or more, it gets a little tricky. The more responses you collect, the harder it gets to read, analyze, and truly understand what people think. That's why surveys are often designed with pre-selected answers to guide participants and simplify data collection. However, pre-defining responses introduces its own set of problems: endless options, overcrowded layouts, and inconsistent answers, especially if you're planning to print your survey. Thankfully, we're no longer tied to physical documents. PDF tools like combo boxes make it easy to offer users a clean preset drop-down menu to select their answers, while allowing them to provide personalized input when necessary, striking the perfect balance between structure and adaptability. Simple yet powerful combo boxes are not only intuitive, but also highly customizable, letting you set formatting rules, require specific fields, and even tailor their behavior to match your needs. It sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? Well, let me show you how simple it is to create drop-down menus with PDFelement. This right here is a questionnaire I want to improve. Instead of overwhelming participants with multiple questions, each followed by a long list of options, I'm going to simplify things by adding combo boxes for each answer. To do this, the first step is to access the drop-down tool, which you'll find under the Form tab. Once I've selected the combo box tool, adding one to the document is as simple as clicking anywhere to place it. Every time you create a combo box, a small window will appear below where you can quickly assign a name, add a tooltip, specify if the field should be required to save or submit, and use the More button to open the full properties menu. But let's take a moment to slow down here, because first we need to understand how our menu behaves. If I switch to view mode, we can see the combo boxes are empty by default. So to make it functional, I'd have to fill the menu with some predefined answers, right? Well, setting up and adding options to a combo box is easier than you might think. Let me show you how to do it. First, we'll need to assess the field's properties menu, either by clicking the More button in the pop-up window or by simply double-clicking the field. Beginning with the General tab, the first field here is the Name field. This is where we need to assign a unique name to the dropdown. Now, the name we need to type in this field isn't about the predefined answers, it's more about the question itself. This will be the name of the entire combo box, so think of it as a way to keep things organized when collecting responses later. Keyword or even the questionnaire number will work just fine. Next, there's the Tooltip field. This is where we can add brief instructions or hints to guide participants on how to interact with the dropdown. And then we have these three options: Visibility, Read Only, and Required. As their names suggest, we can use these to control whether participants can see and interact with a field or if it must be filled out before they can move on. Now let's move on to the Appearance tab. From here we can adjust the look of the drop-down menu to match our designs. We can change the border and background colors, adjust the thickness and style of the borders, and even customize the font style, size, and color to make it visually appealing. And finally, there is the Options tab. This is where we'll add all the answers we want to include in the drop-down menu. In the Item field, you'll add the text participants will see, and in the Export Value field, you'll specify the data that would be collected based on their selection. It's pretty simple, right? Well, in my case, I want participants to rate my service, so I'll repeat this process 4 times to give them 5 different options to answer the question. Once I've done, I can organize the responses in any order I like. If the order follows a logical sequence, like numbers or dates, I can simply check this box to sort them automatically. Finally, for those cases where I know the predefined responses might not cover everything, I can create an option that lets the participants type in their own answers. To do that, all I have to do is enable this checkbox right here. This approach simplifies things for participants and keeps the design of our forms as compact as possible. No more intimidating multi-page forms filled with endless fields to type into. But trust me, the real game changer here isn't just for the participants, it's for you. If you've ever had to sort through piles of messy responses, you know how frustrating and time-consuming that can be. But with tools like Extract Data in PDFelement, you can leverage combo boxes to easily compile all that data into a clean CSV file, ready to analyze and draw meaningful insights in no time. Ready to give it a try? Combo boxes are just the beginning. PDFelement is packed with form features that can transform the way you work. Check out the link in the description below to download and see for yourself how easy and efficient your workflow can be. Thank you for staying with me until the end of this video. If this video was helpful to you, I would appreciate it if you give the video a like and subscribe to this channel. I'll continue bringing you more videos with many tips and tricks to make your work a lot easier. Have a nice day, and I'll see you in the next one.